हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस न्यू टॉपिक डाइजोनियम सॉल्ट। सो डाइजोनियम सॉल्ट्स आर द ऑर्गेनिक सॉल्ट्स विच आर रिप्रेजेंटेड एज Ar(N2)X। सो इन दिस रिप्रेजेंटेशन दिस Ar रिप्रेजेंटिंग एराइल ग्रुप N2 एंड दिस X-। So this X- can be any monovalent anion like chloride, bromide or bisulfate ion. Okay. Now due to the presence of this N2 plus and triple bond and relation, such compounds are known as diazonium. Diazonium. Okay, so this. So the due to the presence of N relation and relation of N with N, such relations are known as diazonium relations. So due to the presence of such relations, these compounds are known as diazonium compounds or diazonium salts. So in this diazonium salt, this N2 plus ion is diazonium ion. Okay. So these are the example of diazonium salts. First is benzene diazonium chloride. Second, benzene diazonium bromide. And the third one is benzene diazonium hydrogen sulfate. Then nomenclature of diazonium salts. So to name these compounds, we use suffix diazonium to the name of parent aromatic hydrocarbon followed by the name of the anion. Okay, so aromatic ring benzene, then diazonium suffix and followed by the anion chloride. Okay students, so in this way by using suffix diazonium we name these compounds. The next is preparation of diazonium salts, and the preparation is from aryl amines by diazotization reaction. Okay, so when diazonium salts are prepared from aryl amines by the process known as diazotization, so diazotization is the process in which diazonium salt is prepared from aryl amines like aniline. Okay, so for the preparation of diazonium salt by aniline, a solution of aniline is prepared first in dilute hydrochloric acid and the solution is cooled in ice cold water. Then ice cold solution of sodium nitrite is added very slowly to the ice cold solution of aniline. Okay, now diazonium salt is formed. This diazonium salt will be diazonium chloride. Okay, so as you can see here, in diazotization reaction we use sodium nitrite and HCl at 273 to 278 Kelvin temperature, means in cold conditions. So by the reaction of these two compound, nitrous acid is formed. So this nitrous acid is a unstable acid, and this nitrous acid is reacting with aniline chloride here, nitrous acid. So this nitrous acid is reacting with aniline chloride and formation of diazonium salt is taking place. Okay, so before the formation of aniline ion, aniline is reacting with hydrochloric acid which is forming aniline chloride, and this aniline chloride is reacting with nitrous acid forming diazonium salt. The next is physical properties of diazonium salts. So in physical properties, These are colorless crystalline solids and usually turn brown on exposure to air. Highly soluble in water. Then chemical properties. And chemical properties of diazonium salt can be divided in two groups. So in first type of chemical properties, in which nitrogen is displaced. In first type, nitrogen gas is liberated. Such chemical reactions. Okay. So in these type of reaction, the first is replacement by hydrogen. So when diazonium chloride is in aqueous condition, is treated with hypophosphorus acid in the presence of cuprous ion as catalyst. So formation of benzene is taking place. So in this reaction, this portion of the diazonium halide is displaced by hydrogen. Okay, so nitrogen is also forming here as a byproduct. Next reaction, replacement by hydroxyl group. So in this reaction, this portion is replaced by OH group. Okay, so for this, aqueous solution of diazonium salt containing a few drops of sulfuric acid is boiled with water. Okay, and in this condition, phenol is formed plus N2 as byproduct and HCl. So overall, this group, diazonium chloride group, is displaced by hydroxyl group in this reaction. Then third is replacement by chlorine or bromine. So this reaction can be very important for you. So in this reaction, N2X group is displaced by Cl or Br. By heating the aqueous solution of the salt with cuprous halide or copper bromide in the corresponding halogen acid. Okay. So when we are heating diazonium salt in the presence of cuprous chloride or bromide with corresponding halogen acid, so such reaction is known as Sandmeyer reaction. Okay, so with the help of Sandmeyer reaction, we can convert diazonium salts in the form of halogen derivative of benzene. For example, when diazonium chloride is treated with cuprous chloride in the presence of HCl, then chlorobenzene is formed and N2 is evolved as a byproduct. Same way, for the preparation of bromobenzene, diazonium salt is treated with cuprous bromide in the presence of HBr. Okay, students? So N2 is formed as a byproduct. Now, same compounds we can prepare with the help of Gutterman reaction. Gutterman reaction, and this reaction is also known as modified form of Sandmeyer reaction. Okay, so in this reaction, instead of cuprous halide, we used just powder of copper. Copper powder we used here instead of cuprous halide. So in the presence of copper powder and the related halogen acid, this diazonium group of the diazonium salt is displaced by chlorine or bromine. Okay, so here also N2 is formed as byproduct. Then last reaction, in which halide formation is taking place, replacement by iodine. So for the replacement by iodine, we use diazonium salt with boiling aqueous solution of diazonium salt with potassium iodide. Okay, so aqueous solution of diazonium salt with potassium iodide. So benzene iodide is formed, or iodobenzene is formed, plus nitrogen as byproduct. So such way we can displace N2Cl group with iodine. And this is the last replacement by fluorine. So this reaction is very important. This reaction is also known as Bach-Schiemann reaction. So in this reaction, the aqueous solution of the diazinium salt is treated with fluoroboric acid. Fluoroboric acid. So when fluoroboric acid is reacted with diazinium salt, benzene diazonium tetrafluoroborate is formed. This is formed, and upon heating, we get fluorobenzene plus nitrogen plus boron trifluoride as a byproduct. So this conversion is known as Bach-Schiemann reaction. The next reaction, or replacement by nitro group. So in this reaction also, diazonium salt is first treated with tetrafluoroboric acid, and tetrafluoroborate is formed. Fluoroboric acid with diazonium salt. So benzene diazonium tetrafluoroborate is formed. And when this is treated with sodium nitrite in the presence of copper, so nitrobenzene is formed as a main product and nitrogen as a byproduct. Okay, so in this reaction, this diazonium chloride group of the diazonium chloride is get displaced with nitro group. Okay, so in first step, diazonium salt is treated with fluoroboric acid, and after this treatment, benzene diazonium tetrafluoroborate is formed, which upon heating in the presence of sodium nitrite and copper, nitrobenzene is formed. Okay, then next reaction, coupling reaction. So in coupling reaction, diazonium salt is reacted with aniline or phenol. So in this reaction, diazonium group of the diazonium salt is retained. Okay, it will be retained there. It will be not displaced, it means, it will be retained there. So, and the product which is formed is known as azo compound. So these azo compounds are having a particular color, and that is why these compounds are used as dye, as a coloring agent, and that is why this reaction is also known as azo dye reaction of the diazonium salt. So for example, as you can see here, in coupling reaction, when diazonium salt is treated with phenol in the presence of basic medium, pH round 9 to 10 at 273 to 278 Kelvin, so para-hydroxy azobenzene is formed, which is a azo dye. Why this is known as azo dye? Due to the presence of this anion relation. So this relation is known as azo bond, and that is why the compound is known as azo compound. Okay, students. So azo dye formed. The second example is with aniline. When aniline is reacting with diazonium chloride, so para amino azobenzene is formed, which is also a azo dye. Okay, students. So these are known as coupling reaction. Coupling reaction in which diazonium salt is reacting with aniline and phenol, forming coloring substances. Okay, then importance of diazonium salt. So diazonium salts are extensively used in dye industry as a coloring agent. Diazonium salts are very useful intermediate in synthesis of large variety of organic compounds, and also these are widely used for the preparation of haloarenes and substituted haloarenes, etc. Okay, students. Thank you.